All right, my name is Justin Rodbell. I'm 20 years old. I'm from Prince Frederick, Maryland, and we're out here in California. Yeah, sort of. So this year I did Daytona Supercross, which is kind of like straight off the couch. I qualified. The goal was like to make the night show. Well, then I qualified 9th, so I was like, okay, well, maybe I can make the main event. And then I put it in the main. That was kind of that. I got a fill-in deal the weekend after with EBR KTM. But then with COVID, everything happened, and they didn't need a rider anymore. So basically, I've been with SGB, and you know, it's been rolling pretty good this summer. We've been putting up some good results, and you know, we're working well together with Jason and I think. So I'm pumped with everything, and pumped to keep it going. Yeah, so Jason's from Maryland, I'm from Maryland, and so he had hit me up probably about a year or two ago about doing my suspension. He's done some suspension for me in the past, and then he hit me up about, you know, he was gonna do a team this year and everything. Basically, I had just gotten back from Australia. I didn't know what I was doing. So he wanted me, we were talking about doing Supercross. That kind of didn't work. But the goal was to do outdoors this summer, like we're doing now. So he's like, hey man, you know, this is what you got to come up with to race this year. So I came up with my part and he did his part, and we're working pretty well together. So I'm pretty pumped on it. Yeah, so the goal where Salt Lake was last minute, obviously. And the goal was just to go out there and see if we had a 250 that was all right for next year. Just to, you know, see if we have a lot of work to do or we don't have a lot. And we have a lot of work to do on our 250, which is pretty known. So we got a lot of work to do after this outdoor series to make this 250 competitive for the 250 season, which I think we can do. It just takes a lot of work. Everyone knows to make a 250 competitive in the 250 class, it's not easy. So yeah, so like I said, I raced in Australia last year. So I had Thor, Bell, Alpine Stars, all that. Well, when you come back to America, you know, those sponsors don't transfer over, you know? It's like, they're one sponsor and here's another. So when I came back, I didn't have anything. So a Fox rep, I bought a helmet, some gear. He had hooked me up with gear and I bought the helmet. And then, so I went to Daytona, raced in the Fox gear. And then A-Ray hit me up for Salt Lake and was like, hey, you know, I got O'Neill and HJC, you wanna hop on board? So I hopped on board for that, and those dudes have treated me so great. O'Neill and HJC brought me in, treated me like one of their own. So next year I'm really pumped to be with them and continue working with them.
Okay, so when Jason first was telling me about you, oh, this Rodbell kid, he looks just like A-Ray when he rides. Like, you guys have a similar riding style, however, you're far smoother and less hard on shit.
Yeah, I'm gonna get a little wild. Like, there's spots where I'm like, whoa. But, I mean, everyone gets a little wild out there. I mean, if you're not pushing the limits, you know, we have to, so I just try my hardest. Yeah, for a dude like me, I mean, it's been pretty well. No one knew of me that well, I think, coming in, so it's like I didn't have crazy expectations. My goals coming into the season were to get a point or two. So to do what I'm doing, like, I've surprised myself. So to do what I'm doing is amazing. I'm pumped with it. And now it's like, you know, every weekend it's like, all right, we'll see if we can do a little better. And we're doing better. I'm pretty consistent. I feel like I'm pretty consistent in the top 15, which is pretty well. So, you know, I just wanted to stay healthy this year, keep it on two wheels, and stay consistent in one position, not be, you know, all over the map. So I feel like I've done pretty well. Yeah, that was pretty cool. Loretta's, we all know, is muddy, right? But people's bikes blew up. But on paper, I got 10th overall. So I'm going to take that as a win and move on. But no, I think I still got 13th at Millville. 13th or 14th at Millville, I don't know for sure. But that's still pretty close to that in a way. I think I've gotten a few 14th, 15th, 16th. Like, so I'm right there. So I'm pretty pumped with that. And you know, top 10 in the 450 class, like growing up, even like battling with like Justin Bogle sometimes, like it's kind of like a surreal to me. There's a lot of like just lining up next to, you know, Tomac. Like when Tomac was a pro, I was probably on a 65. So like I look up to those dudes and lining up to them is like, I have to be like, I can't even like pay attention to them because it's so cool to me. Like, I'm like, all right, you know, we're here to pull a whole shop. Don't look at those guys, because, like, Brock Tickle, like, I mean, I've looked up to that dude for a long time. So there's a lot of guys that me just being on the gate with them is really cool to me. I'm a fan sitting on the gate, which I might sound kind of weird, but I'm a fan of those guys. So first round, I didn't score points. Then I think every round since I've scored points.
So, I mean, you probably have that feeling now of like, yeah, I belong here in the top.
Yeah, I mean, top 15 is like, I fell twice in the second moto WW, and I got back to 19th, which was tough. And for the second moto to fall twice in the first lap and then come back through. But my speed is there, so that's where I should be. I mean, if you look at the lap times, I qualify probably 13th to 15th. Maybe a little better some weekends, maybe a little worse. But wherever I qualify, I finish around there. So I'm pretty happy with that. Like, I'm not qualifying 30th and getting 15th, or qualifying 8th and getting 15th. Like, I'm qualifying 14th, getting 15th, or qualifying 13th, getting 14th. So I'm pumped with that.
Why does your bike last the motos, and why does your teammate have such bad luck?
Dude, I honestly don't know. Like, we all started the season with the same thing. I'm pretty sure round one, Alex blew up a bike, or they pulled him off at round one. Round two, I think he blew up a motor. Second moto, the last lap, which we all know that hurts. So just freak things have been happening with the dude. I mean, he gets a lot of hate, and I mean, sometimes it's needed. Sometimes it's like, oh, I kind of feel bad for the guy, but it's all funny. But it's really, some of the things are not even his fault. Like, the pipe falls off, and then he gets all this hate. I mean, it's all fun and games, but I don't know. Yeah. I mean, my bike's been good, so knock on this van back here. Yeah, I wouldn't say we really, like, we ought to take it serious, but we have a great time doing it. And, I mean, I'm doing well with how it's all working, so I'm not really, don't want to change anything. Mm-hmm. Like, Alex is there, we have a great time. Jeremy, he's a good time. Taylor, our photographer, he's a good time. Jason's fun. Spencer, everyone, like, no one's really like a bad vibe. So we have a good time, you know, we joke around. We've been having some team dinners, those are pretty cool. You know, just getting everyone together, having a good time, riding dirt bikes, like, you can't complain. Yeah, so next year my plan is I'll do stay with SGB. And then, so I'll start whatever coast is first on the 450, yeah. Then whichever coast is second, I'll do 250. So I can do all the rounds, make enough money to try to not have a job, and I'll do all outdoors on the 450, because I'm more of a 450 guy, but I think that 250 Supercross, I think I can do pretty well in, so I'll try one coast on that and the other coast on the 450, and we'll see how it goes, so it should be fun. I'm looking forward to it. Not really.
Really?
Not what you would think. No, but O'Neill, I want to stay with O'Neill, and I want to stay with HJC next year. That's really big for me. So by doing that, there's not much teams out there. They have all their own deals. So, you know, SGB works with me, and they're from Maryland. So, you know, it's cool to stay with a local team, build with them. And I think we can do some good things. You know, it's just their first year as being a team. So I think next year you'll see a lot more from us as professionalism and results. I think we'll do a lot better next year, and equipment, everything. I just think it'll be a better team all around. So, 2021, we're coming out swinging.